Hey guys, John Lee here. I just want to say thank you for tuning in and for checking out the Gravity City YouTube channel. Why don't you subscribe and follow our social media accounts so you can stay up to date and get notified with fresh messages and encouraging content as we want to grace your feed with faith. If you love today's message, feel free to like, comment, and even share it with friends and family. Here in Gravity City, we believe in God's vision He has placed in our hearts for the generations. So if you want to partner substantially with what God is doing in our city through our ministry, please check out our website, www.thecrossroadschurch.online. I'm grateful for you. Love you. Here's today's message. Stay blessed.
I've got a word that's a little bit scary. Is that okay? But before anything else, can you open your Bibles with me in Mark chapter 4, starting from verse 35? Open your Bibles in Mark chapter 4. Starting verse 35, as you're opening up your Bible, I want to tell you, you are welcome in this place. Welcome to Gravity City. If you are here for the first time, you are at the right place at the right time. I believe God has ordained you to be here. If it's your first time in Facebook, somebody just tagged you along in the comment. Somebody just shared this live stream this afternoon. I want to tell you that God never made some mistakes. Amen. He never fails. And I believe that God has a word for you. I believe that as we're going to finish Gravity this afternoon, you will never leave the same. Amen. By the way, my name is Pastor John Lee. And, I just get to lead these people, just this community, this growing community of young professionals, as students, people coming together from different families. We're just a community here. And before I would proceed any further, I want to take this time also to honor two disciples of mine that got married, Mervin, Cherry, Jerry, and Cheeky. The reason why I mentioned that is because one of the greatest joy of a leader is to witness your people, the ones that you're leading, grow through the seasons. And man, I'm just really happy for you guys. We had a deal that as they get married, they're going to explode in ministry. Amen. I said it. That's it. The reason why I brought that up, because I could say it. Anyway, Mark chapter 4. Can I get the charger of this device, this machinery, this computer? It's going to die. Mark chapter 4, verse 35. I want to title this message before I would read. Normally, I would say the title after the scripture, but I want to just change things up a bit. I want to speak from a message called We're Going to the Other Side. We're going to the other side. Can you help announce the sermon title with me? Put it in the chat or on-site team. Say it with me. Say, we're going to the other side. I don't know about you, but I don't know. How many of you wants to be left behind? Nobody wants to be left behind. I pray that I'm going to see you in the other side. Mark chapter 4, verse 35. It says here, on that same day, when evening had come, he said to them, this is Jesus, by the way, speaking. He says, let us go across to the other side. Let us go across to the other side. Leaving the crowd. Man. I just want to stop right there. I believe that before we could proceed in 2021, Jesus wants to make a clear distinction from the crowd and the disciples. Jesus wants to draw the line from the ones who are just following him because of the bread and the fish, and the ones who are willing to go with him to the other side. He says, let us go across to the other side, leaving the crowd. They took him with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. And a great windstorm arose, and the waves were breaking into the boat, so that the boat was already filling. But he was in the stern. I love it. But he was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him and said to him, teacher, do you not care that we are perishing? And he awoke and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he said to them, why are you so afraid? Have you still no faith? And they were filled with great fear and said to one another, who then is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him? Bow your heads with me one more time. Let's ask the Holy Spirit to speak to us through his word. Father, we thank you for every person that's here. I pray that you would not pass anyone by. Lord, I pray that your word, oh God, let it be spoken in clarity, that you would release the spirit of revelation. God, let your word be planted in good ground today, Lord, so that it would bear fruit that would remain. Lord, I pray, oh God, that this time will be a time where we could just encounter you. God, we don't just want to go through a flow or go through some program, God, but we're here for you, Lord, because we want to encounter you, because it is only in encountering you that we can change. God, I pray that you bless everyone that's here. Lord, I pray that you would bless abundantly. Lord, katunay on sa ilang cameras, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I see so many people on the screen. It is so encouraging. Amen. I just told our leaders, dapat mas daghan ang mag-on kaysa dili. I pray 2021 will be a year nga mas daghan imong present kaysa absent. Amen. Mas daghan kag na-devo kaysa na-miss. Amen. Are you guys here? Man, I'm excited because I believe God is calling us to go to the other side. You see, when God releases a promise, there are some promises that actually has its own time frame. Promises, when it comes to past, that doesn't operate in chronos time. Okay. I wish, how many of you would wish that when I receive a promise, I hope, Lord, that you included a date and a time with that promise? Right? How easy could it be? How amazing and awesome would that be when God speaks to us, there'd be a date and a time attached to it, like a reminder. He says, all right, Kenzo, at this date and this time, you're going to meet your future wife. Right, but it doesn't happen like that. Because the promises of God, they don't operate based on Chronos time. They operate based on Kairos time. The Chronos time, by the way, if this is something foreign for you, this term in the Greek actually, you know, is where we get the word chronological, the time, which actually operates in the 24-hour time frame, the 12 months in a year, the 7 days in a week, the 365 days in a year. You see, when God gives you a promise, the promise doesn't operate in Chronos time. It operates in the appointed time. And you getting into the appointed time, I'm here to tell you, is that it's not bound by your time. Though it's called an appointed time, God was so clear to me that getting to the appointed time is bound to your preparedness. It's bound to your becoming. It's bound to your maturity. You see, when God releases a promise, I hope the promise would come to us. No, it's your steps of obedience that leads you to the promise. Are you here? The same way how we're declaring and we're singing the breakthrough is coming. Yes, I believe that there is breakthrough, but I came to announce to you, I'm sorry that the breakthrough won't knock on your door and won't be there in the room when you wake up. Your breakthrough is not going to come to you. Your next level is not going to come to you. You take those steps. And you take those steps by becoming. Are you here? I believe 2021, God has some things in store, but before anything else, he wants to make it clear that you got to make a decision that you're going with him to the other side. What do I mean by the other side? I'm here to tell you that the promise that God has spoken over your life is on the other side. Are you here? The promise that God has for your life sometimes is in the other side. It's in the other side of your obedience. It's on the other side of your faithfulness. It's on the other side of you just keeping on? Is this on the other side of you enduring, of you persevering? Are you here? Is this on the other side? So I'm here to tell you, so many people forfeit the promise because they were expecting that when God gave them a promise, the promise comes to them in a finished form. Are you here? Amen. Are you getting it? Today, I'm going to go straight to the text just once again. Jesus was saying, he was actually the context of the story in chapter 4 of the book of Mark is that Jesus was preaching to the multitudes. He was preaching to thousands of people. He was already in the boat and he was preaching to many people. And after he was done preaching, when evening came, he said that, let's go to the other side. He turned to his disciples and he says, let's go to the other side. And so many times when we receive that word, we get excited. Like, oh my goodness, it's happening. The promise of God has been released. I'm going to be a father of many nations. I'm going to be a leader of leaders. The promise of God has been released. As God said, let's go to the other side. Are you here? But then in the process of going to the other side, the Bible was so clear that the next thing after the instruction was a storm. You see, it's so easy to believe what God told you when things are smooth. It's so easy to believe what God has been speaking to you when you see progress. Come on, somebody. It's easy to believe what God spoke to you when you see some, yes, it's happening, it's happening. But then are there still people in the Zoom who are willing to believe God that when he said, we're going to make it in the other side, even if we're going to go through a storm, you are still a man of your word. You see, the waves began to strike the boat until the water was filling the boat. I believe it was so important that that detail was mentioned. You know why? Because what causes you to drown are not the problems. It's not pressure. It's what gets into you. It's the things that gets inside of you. The problem is you could be in a storm for so long until a time where you begin to break. You begin to break. But I love this part of the text where it says here that the waves were breaking into the boat so that the boat was already filling. Now let me give you some context here. Many of the disciples of Jesus, of course, they were diverse, mixed. I love it. Just look at your cell group. How mixed is that group of people, right? There are the weirdos, the silent type, the weird type, those who, you know, like are so cool, those who whatever. It's like so weird. You go to Save and Free, I've got a weird group of people. Are you here? Are you guys here? Right? And I love it that Jesus was so intentional that he also had diversity in his leadership team. You see, the problem is many times people don't want diversity. They want similarity. And I'm here to tell you that there's no growth in similarity. You only grow with what you know. Growth begins to happen when there are disagreements, when there are diversities. You see, the context I want to give you is that there were fishermen in that boat. You see, when fishermen are in a boat, they know how to work water. Jesus was a carpenter. All right, Jesus, you work wood. We work water. I don't know about you, but when the fishermen in the boat began to panic, that's a sign of a red flag. We're going to die. We are going to die. The fishermen were panicking. But the Bible says that the waves were breaking into the boat so that the boat was already filling. But I love this next sentence, but he was in the stern. You see, I came to tell you, if you've read the Bible long enough, you'd know that the word of God is full of but. B-U-T. The power of the but. Okay, why don't you practice? There's so much power in that three-letter word. Why? Because with that three-letter word, no matter what sentence comes before that word, the power of that word is able to reverse the script. It's able to go against the script. No matter what the word and the sentence was saying. So it says here, the waves were breaking into the boat, but then Jesus kept his peace. You see why? The problem with us is many times we put a period instead of God putting a comma. "2020 got me anxious." We put a period. No, it's not a period. There's a comma, because you can actually declare, "I'm anxious, but Jesus is my peace. I'm exhausted, but Jesus is my strength. I don't know where to go, but Jesus is the way. I'm not sure where I'm going, but Jesus gives me peace." Why don't you start declaring that? That's the power of the three-letter word, that no matter what situation you are in today, you can begin to declare, "I don't know how, but I'm going to praise the Lord. I don't know where I'm going, but the promises to God are secure. Yes and amen. I don't know what 2021 holds, but I'm going to bless the Lord. Oh, my soul." Are you guys here today? We're not discrediting the uncertainty. We're just making a pre-decision that no matter what condition, we already made a decision to praise Him in the midst of the condition. But have you ever been in a point of your life where you ask the question, "Where is Jesus, by the way?" Because if you're honest, you would ask this question. Can I talk to real people here today? Where is Jesus? Where is Jesus? You see, I want to break down the story real quick. I have more things for you. But let's just put our minds as if we're one of those disciples. They were in the boat going where? To the other side. We're going to breakthrough. We're going to harvest. We're going to the promise. We're going to wherever God wants us to go. But as we, in the process of getting there, we are faced with a storm. And they began to panic. But let me give you this truth that's part of the narrative. They were with Jesus. They were with Jesus, but they were afraid. This part of the text suggests to us that it is possible to be in a church, but the word never came to see inside of you anyway. This actually suggests that you can be in cell group and experience revival, but you can be in the same place where Jesus is and not change and not transform and not repent anyway. You see, the problem with the disciples was they were listening to the preaching of Jesus, but they didn't believe what Jesus was preaching. I came to expose these people today in 2021. That sometimes, just because you are in the presence of the church, sometimes the word couldn't get to you. The disciples were with Jesus, and they were still afraid. Moses, for example, encountered God in a form of a burning bush face to face. And after God introduced himself and gave him an assignment, Moses was still afraid. Moses was in the presence of God, but he saw himself. So we can be in the presence of God and give our attention somewhere else. This is dangerous. This is a dangerous place. You see, the problem of our generation is not information. It's wisdom. Wisdom is different from knowledge and understanding. Knowledge brings information. Understanding means comprehension. Wisdom is applied knowledge. So many times we got access to amazing word. You know what I hate to hear? "I'm no longer blessed, Pastor. I'm so dry. Was there a lack of supply in the place where you're rooted in? Psalms chapter 1 talks about a tree planted by the streams of water. That is the perfect imagery and narrative and picture of a mature disciple. Planted by the streams of water so that it is no longer dependent on the external condition. It does not take nutrients from the weather, from the rain. It directly takes nutrients from where it's planted. So that's why I came to tell you that it is possible that some people are not receiving their portion and some people are getting full. So don't you ever blame your cell or your leader or the church when some of them are getting blessed and you are still the same. I'm sorry I didn't come to bring a word that would bring soothing to your itchy ears. But if we're going to make 2021 a great year, we got to deal with some things. The disciples were with Jesus. Are you here? They were with Jesus, but then they acted as if Jesus wasn't with them. But then I love it that God has so much grace that He allows us to go to be in a certain circumstance. God allows us to be in a certain place where He begins to reintroduce Himself. I believe 2021 is a year where God is going to reintroduce Himself. 2020, you've known Him as Jehovah Jireh. You're going to know Him as Jehovah Rapha this year. Last year, you've known Him as a God who restored you. This year, you're going to know Him as a God of breakthrough. I declare in the name of Jesus, God can reintroduce Himself. That's why when Moses asked Him, "What is your name?" God responds, "I am that I am." You cannot put a dot. You cannot put in one adjective the nature of God. Oftentimes, it is in those storms when God introduces Himself differently. He reintroduces. I've been your joy. Now let me let you know, I am your refuge. Let me let you know, last year, I was your protector. I was your shield. This year, I'm going to be your strength. Come on, make some noise for the King of Kings. I'm going to give you a praise break. God's like saying, allow me to reintroduce myself. I am the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the everlasting God who gives strength to the weary and power to the humble. Are you here? I'm here to tell you that sometimes when you're struggling, it doesn't mean that you're getting buried. You're not struggling. You're just in transition. Oftentimes we equate struggle as if it's no longer the will of God because we have bought into the lie that the will of God is always smooth. The safest place to be is in the will of God. Wow. How many of you know sometimes that is not true at all? The best place to be is always in the will of God, regardless whether it's safe or not. It's smooth or easy or dangerous. When we are in the will of God, we are at the right place where we needed to be. But it's not always smooth. I believe, I sense it in my heart. The Holy Spirit began to speak to me. He says, son, there's a lot of your people in 2021. The ones, and here's the deal. It's not a word for everybody. God is a specific word for those that survived 2020. I didn't say that made it to 2020. I meant those that survived the storm. Those that went through the breaking and still standing. Those that are there were about to throw the towel and are still here. God has a word for you. You are going to be in transition. Going to the other side. The promise is in the other side. Things, here's the deal. Did you know that things are easier to deal with when you know it's temporary? The moment you accept the truth that what I'm going through is not permanent. It can be a present reality, but it's not permanent. I'm here to tell you that the moment you accept that truth, the way you face your trouble would be easier because you know that it has an end. What if I tell you that what you're facing has an expiration? That what you're going through has an ending. That the pain you are in, you were in 2020, is going to end. That the questions that you got in your head has an expiration. I'm here to tell you the moment you accept the truth that things are going to end, you can endure whatever you're going through because you know what you're going through has an end to it. Whatever you're facing has an end to it. So if you are facing a home that is dysfunctional, I declare in the name of Jesus, stop. Don't settle. Don't stop fighting because that home, that condition has an end. And God, in that end, is going to shift things to your favor. This 2021, this year, if you'll just begin to position yourself, you're going to witness the glory of God, the faithfulness of God, and how he begins to shift things in your life for your favor. What you're going through has an end. And whatever ends has a new beginning. Woo. Are you here today? Gravity City, help me preach. There's something that God has spoken over your life. If we let it sink in, here's the deal. If the disciples heard what Jesus said, let's go over to the other side because he said it, you're going to make it. In the middle, there's going to be a storm. What if I tell you, is this okay? What if in 2021, we won't get better? It's not going to stop what God promised. I'm looking for people with that kind of faith. The kind of faith just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had that says, even if it does not. Are you here? Are you guys here? You see, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, Paul wrote to those that were struggling. Pastor John Lee, it's weird. 2020 was a tough year. Why are you talking about a struggle in 2021? Because I came to prepare you that whatever you're facing has an expiration. So it does not matter what happens in 2021. It doesn't matter what happens this year. It doesn't happen when the vaccine won't reach yet or we'll be delayed. My healing is not in that vaccine. My healing is in the name of the Lord and the blood of Jesus. My hope is not in people, but in the presence and in the promise of God. I came to prepare you so that not just you're going to have hype in 2021 and then struggle and get defeated in the middle of it. I came to prepare you at the beginning of this year, so that you're not going to settle. So that you're not going to stop fighting. You see, you and I are facing battles that we have no control of. Even if it feels like you're being drained, let me just encourage you, please don't stop fighting. Because victory is in the other side. Paul wrote 2 Corinthians chapter 4, he says, for a light afflictions. But for a moment, Paul begins to define the struggles as light. Where would we be in comparison to the struggles of Apostle Paul? Talking about persecution. Where would you be in comparison, though it's not good to compare? But butang talang. Have you been in a shipwreck, beaten, left for dead, into prison, rejected, stoned, bitten by snakes and scorpions? And then here we are, we say, lisod kayo maslakaw sa Ginoo, wa ko'y pliti. Lisod kayo, sunod sa Ginoo, di ko tagdo ni crush. Paul calls the struggle that he went through light. It compared to the glory that is yet to be revealed. He says, it's light compared to what God is doing. Can I say this? I'm here to tell you that what you're going through is light compared to what God is doing. There's so much weight in what God is doing. So if you're going through some things, if you're struggling, if you're wrestling, I'm here to tell you God is not still if you're going through something. God is not silent if you're going through something. You may not hear him, you may not have some clues, but I'm here to tell you that if you're struggling, God is doing something that's heavier than what you're going through. Are you here? Are you here? It says, while we do not look at things that are seen, but to the things that are not seen. Whew. For the things which are seen are temporary. Right. Okay. I'm going to go back to that. Okay. For the things which are seen are temporary, and the things which are not seen are permanent. Meaning, are you ready for this revelation? If you can see it, it will expire. If you can see the trouble happening in the home, it will expire. If you can see the discouragement that is in your heart, it will expire. Because the things that are seen, come on somebody, the things that are seen are temporary. So if you can see the giant, no matter how big that giant is, it will expire. If you can see the mountain that you're about to overcome, the problem is we're not doing what Jesus said. Instead of speaking to the mountains, we're speaking of the mountain. We're speaking about the mountain. So we go through our cell groups, we go through different people. Hey, did you know about our mountains? We go on Twitter and rant about our mountains. Posting in Facebook. Did you guys know that there's some this mountain? It's so difficult. It's in all these things. But I came to remind you, God didn't tell you to speak about your mountains. He told you to speak to your mountains. Mountains, move. I'm going to pass. So if you can see it, it will expire. It will expire. Let's go back to the text in Mark chapter 4. The amazing thing about Jesus is that while the disciples were panicking and they woke Jesus up, they saw the storm, right? Right? It stopped. They woke Jesus up. I love it. That even while the waves were beating the boat and it was filling the boat with water, it says, but Jesus was asleep, in deep sleep. I came to my imagination, what was Jesus dreaming at that moment? Probably he was dreaming about heaven, and he was dreaming about things that are heavenly, the four living creatures that were in Revelations. He was dreaming all those things. And then suddenly somebody woke him up. And these were the words that he heard. Jesus, don't you care that we're going to die? Jesus goes out, and here's the deal. The one thing, I'm going to show you a character of Jesus. Jesus, yes, first, he dealt with the external circumstance. Why? Because he went out, and he spoke to the waves. He says, be still. So the waves stopped. But you know what? Jesus spent more time not in the waves. He spent more time correcting his disciples. Why were you afraid? Why do you have little faith? So many times we think that just because God restored, God saved you from trouble, God saved you and like, yay, I'm free. No, sometimes God confronts you. He says, you know, I'm not worried about the storm. I'm worried about what's inside of you. I'm not worried about COVID in 2021. I'm more worried about your heart posture towards this year. Because what matters to God most or more are not what happens around you, it's what happens inside of you. So he begins to correct his disciples. The waves, yes, they stopped. But then Jesus began discipleship right at that moment. He says, why were you afraid? Why were you still afraid? Are you here? Are you here? Are you guys here? Hallelujah. We spend all our time working on something that's temporary. Right? In our culture, in our time, we spend more and invest more than we put on our body than rather in our soul. Right? Right? How can I prove this? Look at your yearbook. Look at your throwback photos when you thought during that time that you were so trendy. Naglingin mo balik, uy, gym mo loda na ko. Why? Because it expired. Right? Sometimes we're more busy putting makeup on our faces. Right? The face you have now is not going to be the face you have 40 years from now. It expires. Are you guys here? Even trends expire. Our problem is that our eyes are not fixed on the promise. It's fixed on the temporary situation around us. The seen and the unseen. The visible and the invisible. But you're so fixed on what you see. Imagine how many mistakes you could have avoided if you saw things with a different lens. Comparison. When the disciples and Jesus are there, were they in the same boat? Come on, answer. Were they in the same boat? Then why Jesus was asleep? Because the disciples panicked because they saw their eyes were fixed on the storm. Jesus wasn't fixed on the storm. It was fixed on the unseen. My prayer for you 2021, Gravity City, is that you become people, young men and women, young professionals, who prioritizes more the unseen this year. Are you here? The thing is, the visible world has a voice. And you can either listen to what the world is saying or listen to what the Word is saying as we step into 2021. The visible world has a voice. And that's the voice that knows every secret that you have, that messes up with your confidence in Christ. The voice that gets you back to your past. The voice that tells you right after victory, that tells you you're not worthy, you're not going to make it, you're still the same person. The voice that tells you at night that you're still this and you're that, you're leading. How can you serve if you're struggling with this sin? That voice. Either you're going to listen to the world or to the Word. Are you guys here? Amen. Amen. The problem is when we are in the temporary situation, when we are in that temporary situation, there's so many people that make permanent decisions in that temporary condition. So imagine how many people forfeit God's blessing because they made a permanent decision in a temporary condition. Are you here? Are you here? Are you guys here? Jesus is in the same boat. He was preaching to the multitudes. Let us go to the other side. But the problem with the disciples was that they were with the preacher, but they did not believe the preaching. Are you here? The Word was no longer getting inside of them. As a cell leader, that breaks my heart. Because while you are aware that people need to respond many times because of the fear of rejection and the fear of losing relationships, we would rather stay silent than confront. 2021, I pray that confrontation will take a new norm in our culture. That we won't be offended when we are confronted. That we will learn the difference between correction and judgment. that we will become people and disciples that would say, correct me, I'm gonna listen. Are you here? Is this good? Is this good? When we start to see things by faith, the way God sees it, the moment you make that decision to see things by faith, seeing things by faith is seeing things the way God sees it. I'm here to tell you, you could now begin to call things in the invisible to the visible. If you begin to see things not as they are, but things the way they could become, you could begin to call the things in the unseen. Because faith is the tool and the transportation that brings what is in the unseen to manifestation. You can now begin to call things. Are you guys here? Are you guys here? Can I bring you back to Adam? When he was tasked by God, before the fall, Adam walked on glory. The glory of God was upon Adam. God gave him an assignment. That assignment confirmed his authority. What was the authority that Adam had? To call things, and whatever he calls it becomes it. You may just see it as some weird job and some work, but what he spoke, heaven backed up. When he says that this creation is this, the word of God backs his word, that it becomes a reality. During the fall and after the fall, the glory of God, we fell short from the glory. But God is restoring the faith and the glory in Christ. That faith actually gives us the ability to call things as though they are, though they're not. Are there people in the Zoom today who have so much faith to call things as though they are, though they're not? How many people have so much faith in 2021 to not let their condition dictate their conviction? Are you here? But to call things as though they are, though they're not, until it manifests. So when you walk into a broken family, don't call what you see. Call what you believe. I don't see depression. I see restoration in the name. Call it as it is. Begin to call things. If you've got so much faith, the Bible says, I believe, therefore I spoke. Right. Are you here? I believe, therefore I spoke. Amen. So what are you looking at? Where's your eyes fixed? Is it fixed on the temporary things or in the heavenly? 2021, where's your eyes going to be fixed? What are you looking at? Did you know that even in the relationships that you choose to be in is actually a glimpse of the value in how you see yourself. People say, I'm in a toxic relationship. It's not healthy for me. It's this and that. And why are you allowing it? The person is cheating on me. And why are you allowing it? It's because it depends on how you saw yourself. The value that you see. You see, the moment you begin to understand who you are in Jesus, you're going to teach people how to treat you. You cannot control what they do to you, but you can train them in how to treat you. I'm not going to allow these things. Why? Because I know my value. I know who I am in Jesus Christ. People are going to call you, you're still the same person. You're this and you're that. But you begin to believe I am who he says I am. Not what you claim. Are you here? So what are you looking at? Is this okay? I'm going to call the worship team to come. But I'm going to take you in a deeper word. In Jeremiah 12. And then we're going to end. Jeremiah 12. Verses 1 to 5. You see, Jeremiah had a difficult assignment. Today, I'm going to prepare you for 2021. There will be storms. The struggle will not disappear. Just because we declare 2021 is our year doesn't mean that there will be an absence of struggle. There will be an absence of pain. My assignment for you this afternoon is to prepare you for what's to come. In Jeremiah chapter 12, verses 1 to 5, catch this. The Bible says, Jeremiah spoke in behalf of the people. You see, are there any people that are frustrated with their lives? Can I be honest? Put that in the chat. Are you frustrated sometimes? You see, Jeremiah had a difficult assignment. Because Jeremiah was assigned and tasked to speak to a people who were all frustrated. Because the Israelites in the time of Jeremiah, catch this, were people who were witnessing freedom for their families and friends while they were still in captivity. The Israelites in the time of Jeremiah were witnessing their friends and family getting prosperous, getting set free while they remain in captivity. So they complained to Jeremiah and told Jeremiah, Jeremiah, we want you to talk to God in behalf of our frustration. Thus, Jeremiah 12, verse 1 begins. It says, righteous are you, O Lord, when I complain to you, yet I would plead my case before you. Why does the way of the wicked prosper? Can I paraphrase it? Jeremiah, in behalf of the people, were like telling God, God, Lord, I know you. And you always made wise decisions. But I want to talk to you about your recent choices. Why do the wicked prosper? Is there any leader that felt this way? That as you are being devoted to the ministry that you're called to, you begin to witness, some people just live their lives. Some people just enjoy. Some people just walk away when they want to. And then here you are and you're like, God, I'm serving. I'm leading here. And then you begin to say in your heart, why do the wicked prosper? Or, shall I rephrase it? Why do the unfaithful seem so happy? And why am I here? Why does the way of the wicked prosper? Why do all who are treacherous thrive? You plant them and they take root. They grow and produce fruit. You are near in their mouth, but far from their heart. What Jeremiah was actually saying is that he says, God, these people who pretend to be close with you, but in reality they're not. Why do they prosper? Why do they seem happy? In other words, what Jeremiah was actually saying is that he was saying, God, you know how faithful I've been. And you know those people that just let go anytime. But why am I struggling? Why am I struggling? You see, the Israelites had a messed up theology in this scripture. Because they thought that God released their blessing and delivered it to the wrong address. Why are other people being set free, not us, the one in covenant? The Israelites had a wrong theology. They thought that God's blessing went to the wrong address. That what was supposed to be for me went to somebody else. I came to tell you today, never be jealous with what God has done for other people. Because what is for you is for you. What is for them is for them. And if God bless your neighbor, that means he is in the neighborhood. And I'm next. I'm going to be next. I'm just going to stay faithful.